This is the story of Peter and the Wolf. It's a story with music, where each character is represented by an instrument of the orchestra. The bird by the flute. The duck by the oboe. The cat by the clarinet. The wolf by three horns. Peter, our hero, by the strings of the orchestra. Grandfather by the bassoon. And the hunter's rifle shots by the timpani and the bass drum. One beautiful morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the great green meadow. On the branch of a large tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. All is quiet, she chirped cheerily. All is quiet. Just then, a duck came waddling along. She was delighted that Peter had left the gate open. and seeing the deep pond in the meadow, decided to take a nice swim and dived in. Seeing the duck, the bird flew down upon the grass and settled next to her. Shrugging her shoulders, she said, "What kind of bird are you that can't fly?" To this the duck replied, "What kind of bird are you that can't swim?" Huh! And jumped into the pond. They argued and argued, the duck swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the bank. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. It was a cat crawling through the grass. The cat was thinking, "That bird is so busy arguing, I'll just grab her." Stealthily, she crept towards her on her velvet paws. "Look out!" cried Peter. And the bird immediately flew up into the tree. The duck quacked angrily at the cat. From the middle of the pond. The cat crawled around the tree and thought, "Is it really worth climbing up so high? By the time I get there, that bird will have flown away." Grandfather came out. He was angry that Peter had gone out into the meadow. "It's a dangerous place. What if a wolf should come out of the forest? Then what would you do, eh?" Thank you. Peter paid no attention to his grandfather's advice. Boys such as he are simply not afraid of wolves. Grandfather took Peter by the hand, led him home, and locked the gate. No sooner had Peter gone than an enormous grey wolf came out of the forest. In a twinkling, the cat climbed up the tree. The duck quacked and, in her excitement, foolishly jumped out of the pond. No matter how hard she tried to run, she could not escape the wolf. He was getting nearer and nearer, catching up with her. And then he got her, and with one gulp, swallowed her. And now, this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The bird on another. Not too close to the cat. wolf walked round and around the tree, looking up at them with greedy eyes. In the meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood by the wall watching all that was going on. He ran home, took a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall. Now, one of the branches of the tree under which the wolf was lying stretched out over this wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter lightly climbed over onto the tree. Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle the wolf's head. Only take care that he doesn't catch you." The bird almost touched the wolf's head with her wings, while the wolf snapped angrily from this side and that. The bird was driving the wolf mad, and oh, how the wolf wanted to catch her. But she was far too clever, and he simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso. Carefully letting it down, caught the wolf by the neck and pulled with all his might. Realizing he was caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. Peter tied the other end of the rope to the tree, and the wolf's jumping only made the rope around his neck even tighter. just then. The hunters came out of the forest. Following the wolf's trail and shooting as they went. "Don't shoot!" cried Peter. "Bertie and I have already caught the wolf. Now you can help us take him to the zoo." And now, imagine the triumphant procession. Peter, our hero, at the head. Then came the hunters leading the wolf. Winding up the procession, Grandfather and the cat. Grandfather shook his head discontentedly.
"And what if Peter hadn't caught the wolf? What then?"
Thank you.
Above them flew Birdie, chirping merrily. My, what fine heroes we are, Peter and I. Look what we've caught. If anyone had listened carefully, they would have heard the duck quacking inside the wolf's belly, for in his hurry, he had swallowed her alive.